A fabulous good afternoon to everyone. In front of you, this is Sai Kumar Swero from Bellampally COE, Manchurial District. So friends, today I am going to teach you a very, very interesting topic. So friends, before the topic, first let us know the basic concepts of today's our topic. So friends, today we are going to discuss the very basic concepts for today our topic. So friends, we all know that of every living organisms on this earth, they are developed from a single cell. Those are zygote. Later, with the zygote, they will develop into embryo. So friends, anybody have an idea how the organs, how the tissues are developed from embryo? So friends, I want to pose another question for you. Are you ready to answer my questions? Okay, friends. So friends, how many types of blood cells are present in our body? Yes, friends, you are absolutely correct. There are three types of blood cells are presented in our body. One is red blood cells, second one is the white blood cells, and third one is the blood platelets. So friends, actually, the every blood cell have a particular finite lifespan. After the completion of their finite lifespan, they'll totally destroy in our body. So friends, can we imagine we can live without the blood cells? No friends, no, it can't possible, right? Without blood cells, how can we live? But friends, anybody have an idea how will they regenerate? So friends, let's find the answers. Let's find the reasons for the above questions through today our topic. So friends, today we are going to discuss about why are stem cells so important. Explain with special emphasis on their medical benefits. So friends, today we are going to discuss about why are stem cells so important. Explain with special emphasis on their medical benefits. So friends, the contents today I am going to deal are: what are stem cells, history of stem cells, types of stem cells, characteristics of stem cells, medical benefits of stem cells, obstacles of stem cell research, and regulations on stem cell research, and final one is the conclusion. So friends, these are the contents today I am going to deal as part of my topic. So friends, first let us know what are stem cells. So friends, stem cells are biological cells that can differentiate into other types of cells, and they have a capability to renew themselves. So that is the specialty of stem cell. For example, let us take here, this is a one stem cell. So friends, this stem cell can convert into cardiac cell. This stem cell also convert into muscle cell. So this stem cell can convert into nerve cell. So this is the specialty of the stem cell. So friends, why it is important in our body? For example, let us take here, this is the machine and this is the human being. So friends, the machine have a different types of parts. At the same time, the human beings also have the same types of parts and functions, right? So but friends, if suppose any parts are damaged in the machine, automatically we can repair, right? But it possible to repair in the human beings? Friends, I think the most of the people will say it can't possible. How to repair these organs in our body? It can't possible. But friends, it is absolutely wrong. We can repair our organs, we can repair our cells by using the stem cells. So that is the specialty of stem cell. So friends, let us discuss the history behind the stem cell. So friends, in the year of 1908, the first time Alexander Maximov, a Russian histologist, he coined the term stem cells. After 60 years, it means in the year of 1968, the scientists from Canada like Till and McCulloch, they discovered the self-renewing cells in the bone marrow of the mouse. So after, in the year of 1999, first successful human transplant of insulin making cells from cadavers. In the year of 1999, first successful human transplant of insulin making cells from cadavers. So friends, after in the year of 2001, the president, the president of the US, George Bush, he restricted the federal funding for embryonic stem cell research. After, in the year of 2002, the Juvenile Diabetes Research Foundation, they donated exactly $20 million to support the stem cell research. After, in the year of 2003, the California permitted stem cell research. So, in the year of 2004, the Harvard researchers grabbed the stem cells from embryos using the private funding. So, friends, this is the history behind stem cell research. So, friends, let us know what is the history behind human embryonic stem cell research. So, friends, in the year of 1998, James Thompson, he isolated the cells from early embryo and is the first person to develop the first human embryonic stem cell lines. In the same year, John Gerhardt, he derived the human embryonic germ cells from primordial cells. From primordial cells, he derived the human embryonic germ cells. So, friends, this is the history behind the human embryonic stem cell research. So, friends, now we are going to discuss about types of stem cells. So, friends, they are classified, mainly the stem cells are classified into broadly into two criteria, based on their potency, based on their sources. First, let us clarify the types of stem cells based on their potency. So, friends, based on their potency, they are classified into three types. One is totipotent stem cell, second one is a pluripotent stem cell, and third one is the multipotent stem cell. First, let us know what are totipotent stem cells. So, friends, totipotent stem cells, they have an ability to develop into a complete new individual organ. So, friends, we can find this totipotent stem cells in early embryo from 1 to 3 days. In the early embryo of 1 to 3 days, we can find this totipotent stem cell. After, in the year of, after the pluripotent stem cell. So, friends, a pluripotent stem cell have an ability to turn over 200 cell types. They have an capability to turn over 200 cell types. So, friends, we can find these stem cells in blastocyst from 5 to 14 days. After, the third one is the multipotent stem cell. So, friends, what are multipotent stem cells? The multipotent stem cells have a capability to differentiate into a less number of tissues. Those are called as a multipotent stem cell. We can find these multipotent stem cells in fetal tissue, cord blood tissue, and also in adult stem cells. So, friends, let us discuss about the types of stem cells based on source. So, friends, based on their sources, they are divided into three types. One is embryonic stem cell, second one is the adult hematopoietic stem cell, and third one is the induced pluripotent stem cell. First, let us clarify what are embryonic stem cells. So, friends, embryonic stem cells are a type of stem cells which are isolated from the inner cell mass of blastocyst. We will call them as a embryonic stem cell. So, friends, this is a very detailed about embryonic stem cell. So, let us discuss what are adult hematopoietic stem cells. So, friends, before entering to our topic, we discussed about blood cells, right? So, friends, here we are able to see the bone marrow, right? So, friends, the bone marrow is divided into two types. One is red bone marrow, second one is the yellow bone marrow. Friends, these red bone marrow characteristic is to produce the blood cells, and yellow bone marrow capability is to produce the tissues. So, friends, these red bone marrow contain adult hematopoietic stem cell. So, this is the reason to produce the blood cell. Friends, I think you have a clear idea about this adult hematopoietic stem cells, right? So, friends, Now we are going to discuss about adult hem. Already we discussed about adult hematopoietic stem cells, right? So friends, now we are going to discuss about the third important stem cell is the induced pluripotent stem cell. So friends, we can find this induced pluripotent stem cell. We can produce this induced pluripotent stem cells from any type of tissues or any type of cell by using some of the chemical process and also by using some different types of chemical. So friends, the pluripotent stem cells characteristics are very similar to the properties of embryonic stem cells. So friends, now I think you have a clear idea about types of stem cells, right? So friends, now we are going to discuss about the characteristics of stem cells. So friends, what are the characteristics of stem cells? So look at to the screen, friends. So friends, the characteristics of stem cells are cell division. First, let us know what is a cell division. So friends, we all know that stem cells are unspecialized cells, right? So friends, these have a capability to renew themselves by using this cell division method. So the second one is a cell differentiation. We know about cell division, right? So the second one is a cell differentiation. So friends, we all know that the stem cell have a capability to turn into an organ, right? So they have a capability to turn into an organ by using the cell differentiation method. So the third interesting characteristic is the repairing capability. So friends, here we can see that the third one is the repairing capability. So friends, we all know that in adult organism, the stem cells and the progenitor cells, they will act like as a repairing system. So friends, they will act like as a repairing system. Friends, if you take example, not only as a repairing system, they will also act like as a bodybuildings of our life. So friends, now we are going to discuss about applications of stem cells in medical fields. So friends, the cell replacement therapy. First, the stem cells are used in cell replacement therapy. So friends, for example, if you take here a kidney patient. So friends, we see that the kidney patient should require a transplant and also donor, right? So instead of that, it should have to require a lot of time and also it should require a particular kidney, right? So instead of that, we can use the stem cells into that particular damaged kidney. So this is called as a cell replacement therapy. So friends, these cell replacement therapy are also used for muscular dystrophies, hemophilia, Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's disease, and also arthritis, diabetes, etc. For these diseases, we can use the cell replacement therapy. Clear? So friends, not only for these, the stem cells are also used for understanding cell specialization. So it is useful to study about the human pluripotent stem cell. We can get how the stem cells are converting into specialized cells. And also we will get a knowledge about the basic knowledge about the human development. And also it is useful for creating some of the somatic cell aging. So friends, the third one is the stem cell also used in developing and testing of drugs. So friends, along with these benefits, the stem cells are also used for blindness disease. So friends, recently Moorfields Eye Hospital in London, they successfully restored the visions of 6 people who lost their eyes because of chemical accidents. And not only for chemical accidents, and also degenerative diseases. So friends, degenerative diseases, they used the stem cells. So friends, in our state, a research team headed by Subhadra Jalali from LV Prasad Eye Hospital, they finding a focus long-term treatment for retinal degenerative disease, especially on retinitis pigmentosa. So friends, we can see the possible uses of stem cell technology. The possible uses of stem cell technology is for replacing the tissues or organs, repair of defective cell types, and also it is used for delivery of genetic therapies and also for delivery of chemotherapeutic agents. So friends, along with these benefits, there are some obstacles of stem cell research. So let us find what are the obstacles we are facing during the stem cell research. The first obstacle is finding the right type of stem cell, and the second one is how to put the stem cell into the right place, and the third one is the embryonic stem cells are unstable and also they mutate in culture. So friends, in nowadays, along with these obstacles, there is a some of the ethical debate also there. So friends, we all know that the embryonic stem cells are very powerful than the other stem cells, right? So friends, in nowadays, the scientists are harvesting the embryonic stem cells by using the different types of methods. They are destroying the blastocyst. Friends, it is treated as a murder, and also at the same time, it is treated as a devalues the life. So friends, regulations on stem cell research. So friends, in India, the ethical guidelines for biomedical research on stem cells were published by ICMR, means Indian Council for Medical Research, in the year of 2000. At the same time, along with the ICMR, the Drugs Control General, they also published some of the good regulations and also some guidelines based on World Health Organization standards. So friends, here we are able to see the countries which appear in the red region, like Canada, most of the Asian countries, and along with including India, Australia, South Africa, they are conducting the successful stem cell researches. So friends, the stem cells may also have a scope for drug discovery and also for transplantation purpose. And also stem cells may have a offer for patient-specific stem cell therapy. So friends, nowadays there are some of the current possible uses of stem cell technology. So let us know what are the current possible uses of stem cell technology. Friends, the human embryonic stem cell researchers are using this stem cell technology for various diseases like Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's disease, heart stroke, epilepsy, neurodegeneration, trauma. For these diseases, we are using the stem cell technology. So friends, hence I would like to conclude that research in stem cells has opened up a new horizons in the area of treatment of disorders. At the same way, current research is aimed at finding the appropriate sources of stem cells for a given indicating ways. Means friends, we can say that in nowadays, it is becoming as a barrier for our future needs, for future of our medicine. In nowadays, the doctors are collecting the stem cells from umbilical cord and they are storing them in the stem cell bank at certain conditions. So for our further needs, friends, for that we should have to save our stem cells for our further needs. So friends, hence I would like to be very thankful for our Supreme Sphero, Dr. R.S. Pravin Kumar sir, and also for my guide teacher, Rajkumar sir. And I especially thankful for Professor Vidya Madam, who suggested me. And finally, I would like to thankful for my Ainala Saidul sir, who supported me to participate in this Super Student event. Thank you. Have a nice day.